Let us discuss the relation in drift velocity and current density of a conductor. Now, here this is a setup in which we can see a cylindrical conductor is connected via battery. And we are also given that in this conductor, free electron density is n electrons per meter cube. Now, if the switch is closed down, a current is established in clockwise manner. And all the free electrons will on an average start moving toward left with the drift velocity Vd. Now in this situation we know that we can easily calculate the value of current as rate of charge. So if we consider a cross section, say this is a cross section M1 through which if an electron is passing, we know well that in a unit time electrons will travel a distance on an average distance equal to Vd. So any electron which is crossing this section M1, after 1 second in a unit time it will cover a distance Vd and it will reach to the another section M2 over here. Now in this situation we can see all those electrons which are there in the region between these two sections, in 1 second or in a unit time all these will cross the section M2 and will come forward. So here we can say, we can also write number of electrons crossing a section in conductor per unit time are equal to the total volume of this region, can be written as the cross sectional area multiplied by the length Vd. If we consider the area of cross section of this conductor as S, this can be written as, this volume can be written as SVd, and small n electrons are there per meter cube. So total number of electrons crossing a section in a unit time can be written as NSVd. And if we calculate the charge flow per unit time, that we can write as current. That will be NSVd multiplied by the charge of electron, because these much electrons are passing in 1 second. So here we can calculate the current density in the conductor, which is J, and it can be written as I by S. So this can be written as NEVd, or the drift velocity of electrons in the conductor can be written as J over NE. That is a quite useful relation between current density and the drift velocity. You should always keep in your mind, because in various calculation and derivations of upcoming results, we are going to use this relation quite frequently.